So our last objective for this chapter relates now to manufacturing overhead variances. As we know from previous coursework, we have two types of overhead, fixed and variable. So we'll first start looking at what comprises the variable overhead variance. Now, what you'll find is that variable overhead variances are very similar to variances for direct materials and direct labor. The variable overhead variance is split into what we call the spending variance versus a price or rate variance that's used for the direct materials and direct labor. But they're interpreted, in essence, the same way. And then there's also the efficiency variance for variable overhead, which is related to the efficiency of the allocation base for variable overhead. And of course, the spending variance plus the efficiency variance equals the flexible budget variance. Now, fixed overhead is a bit of a special animal. The first thing you'll notice here is that it's broken up into two variances, the budget variance and the volume variance. Now, the budget variance is just the difference between the actual fixed overhead versus the budgeted fixed overhead. If you try to trace through the fixed overhead variances, you'll find that the static budget and flexible budget for fixed overhead are the same. And that means that the budget variance, or the static budget variance, is equal to the flexible budget variance, which is actually equal to the fixed overhead spending variance. They're all the same variance. And what you'll also find, and this is really important, is there is no efficiency variance for fixed overhead. And that's how you can have the budget variance basically be equal to the flexible budget variance and the fixed overhead variance. But what's different about the fixed overhead variance from all the other variances is this volume variance, which we also call the production volume variance. And we can call that PVV if you like. Well, all that is the difference between the applied fixed overhead and the budgeted fixed overhead. That's it. So let's just quickly review this now in the context of the textbook example. So here we have actual results and the flexible budget amount and of course the flexible budget variance. So if we just look at variable overhead first, we see actual variable overhead of 9,000 and flexible budget of 8,000 with an unfavorable variance of $1,000. And we can see how those are broken up into the spending and efficiency variances. So what we have for variable overhead is we have an actual rate multiplied by an actual quantity. In the earlier part relating to direct materials and direct labor, we used AP for actual price. You can do that here too, it doesn't really matter, as long as you're consistent with how you use the variables. Then in the middle, we have the standard rate times the actual quantity. And you can see that what's the same between these two is the actual quantity, and what differs is the actual variable overhead rate versus the standard overhead rate, which is the same thing as direct materials and direct labor. If we look at the efficiency variance here, the standard rate still applies, and we multiply that by the flexible budget quantity, and that will give us an efficiency variance. So you can see how this is the same as direct materials and direct labor. Here we can see how the fixed overhead budget variance is just the difference between the actual fixed overhead and the budgeted fixed overhead. So 12,300 versus 12,000 is an unfavorable variance. It's the difference between the fixed overhead that's budgeted and the fixed overhead that's applied based on the actual usage of the cost driver that results in this very special production volume variance. Here we have the same 12,000 budgeted fixed overhead amount, but the amount that's applied is 15,000, leaving a production volume variance of 3,000 favorable. It's favorable because the company should only have applied 12,000 in fixed overhead, but ended up applying 15,000, so it went a little too far. And of course, that ends up on the income statement. So the adjustment that would need to be made to apply the correct amount of overhead would be a $3,000 adjustment, which would work to reduce the cost of goods sold on the income statement. So let's work through this in-class problem on flexible budgeting and overhead variances. Here we have Bhutan Glass Works with the production budget for the year ended November 30th, 2021 in a certain department was based on 200,000 units. Each unit requires 2 standard hours of labor. Total overhead was budgeted at 900,000 for the year, and the fixed overhead rate is $3 per unit. Both variable overhead and fixed overhead are applied on the basis of direct labor hours. And then here's the actual data. So we have actual production, actual direct labor hours, actual variable overhead, and fixed overhead. Our first objective is going to be to determine the standard hours allowed for actual production for the year ended. Well, that's really the same thing as the flexible budget quantity of labor hours, or what I just call the FQ. Well, here, FQ is simply equal to our actual production quantity times the 2 hours required of labor. So 198,000 units times the two standard direct labor hours per unit. So that works out to 396,000 direct labor hours. And you'll see where we use that later on. All our other requirements can basically be categorized into two groups, the ones related to the variable overhead variances and the ones related to the fixed overhead variances. So what we'll do first is put together our variable overhead efficiency and spending variances. I like to illustrate it using the flowchart approach that we've become accustomed to. So we'll start from the left. We'll start from the left where we're going to have an actual quantity of driver, in this case, direct labor hours, times the actual variable overhead cost rate. We know from the data that the actual quantity of labor used is 440,000. And we're going to multiply that by, and we're going to multiply that by the actual variable overhead cost rate. But if we go and look at the data, it doesn't tell us what the actual variable overhead cost rate is, but what it does tell us is the total actual variable overhead. And so if we know that the total actual overhead is $352,000, we can divide that into 440,000 to determine the rate of 80 cents per direct labor hour. So that's the actual variable overhead cost rate. Now, if we go to the middle, we also use the actual quantity of the cost driver, but this time we multiply by a standard rate for variable overhead. Well, we already know that 440,000 is the actual number of direct labor hours used. And I need to go to my data and find what the standard overhead rate is. But no matter how hard you look, you won't find it. So what we have to do is use some other information that we have available to us, notably that the total overhead is 900,000 and the fixed overhead rate is $3 per unit. So here's what we have. We have total budgeted overhead of $900,000. And we know from previous coursework that total overhead is actually split into fixed overhead and variable overhead. Well, we know that the budget is based on 200,000 units times $3 per unit means that our total fixed overhead must be $600,000. Okay, well, if our fixed overhead is 600,000 and the total overhead is 900,000, that means that the variable overhead must be 300,000. So now we have enough information to figure out what the variable overhead cost rate is. We would take 200,000 units and we would multiply by 2 hours per unit because each unit requires 2 hours of labor per unit and our cost driver is direct labor. And then I would multiply that by my variable overhead rate to end up with $300,000. But I don't know the overhead rate. But what I do know is that 200,000 units times 2 direct labor hours is 400,000 direct labor hours. And if I take my 300,000 in total budgeted overhead and divide by 400,000 hours, I will get 0.75 per hour. And that is how I end up with 300,000 in variable overhead. So again, this is $300,000 divided by 400,000 direct labor hours. This is a good little twist on the problem. It's not complicated if you understand that total overhead is equal to fixed and variable. And if you have the fixed overhead, then you can back calculate the variable overhead and then the associated rates. So this is what we need now to solve the rest of our problem. So if I multiply the 440,000 direct labor hours times the 75 cent per direct labor hour standard rate, that will give me 330,000. And if I take the difference between those two, I'll get a 22,000 unfavorable variable overhead spending variance. Now that was a long way to do it, but when you get good at it, you start to see the differences and the similarities in the equation. So holding the actual quantity constant, this is the same thing as AQ times the difference between the actual rate minus the standard rate. Well, isn't that the same as 440,000 times the difference between an actual rate of 80 cents minus 0.75? Now, we'll solve the last part on the far right, where we will have our standard rate multiplied by our FQ, or flexible budget quantity. Well, the standard rate is the 75 cents, but in here we multiply by our flexible budget quantity, which we already calculated to be 396,000 hours. So when I multiply those two together, this means I should have used 297,000 direct labor hours in the production of 198,000 units. If I take the difference between these two, this is a 33,000 unfavorable variable overhead efficiency variance. And again, we can also put our formula together now, holding the standard rate constant and multiplying by the difference between the actual quantity of the variable cost driver minus the flexible quantity of the cost driver. We have 0.75 times 440,000 hours minus 396,000 hours to give us our 33,000 unfavorable. So there you have your variable overhead spending and efficiency variances. And of course, if we just take the difference between the two or add the variances together, we end up with a $55,000 unfavorable variable overhead flexible budget variance. The explanation we have here is quite simple. Whatever comprises the variable overhead ended up costing more than the budget, right? 80 cents per hour versus 75 cents. So the production manager would undertake an investigation to figure out why the constituent costs related to variable overhead increased. And then also, we have an unfavorable efficiency variance because more direct labor hours were used. Well, the reason for this would be exactly the same as the direct labor efficiency variance, just using a different cost attached to it. So we would look to investigate why more direct labor hours were used to produce 198,000 units than should have been used, because that's a significant amount. So that was all for the variable overhead variances. And now we'll do the same for the fixed overhead variances. So we need the fixed overhead spending variance. We want to determine how much fixed overhead was applied and then calculate the fixed overhead production volume variance. We can do this visually in the same way with three columns. On the left, we'll have our actual fixed overhead. In the middle, we'll have our budgeted fixed overhead. And it doesn't matter if this is the static budget or the flexible budget. Remember, they're the same thing. And then on the right, we'll have our applied fixed overhead. Our actual fixed overhead is provided for us at $575,000. The budgeted fixed overhead should be the $600,000 we actually already calculated. Remember, 200,000 units times $3 a unit, 600,000. And the applied overhead is based on 198,000 units produced. These are actual units, times the $3 fixed overhead rate. And that gives us a total of $594,000. If we wanted to determine what the actual fixed overhead rate was, we could just take 575,000 and divide by 198,000 units, and that would give us a rate of $2.90. So what we have is a budget variance, but this is also known as the static budget variance, which is also known as the flexible budget variance, which is also the fixed overhead spending variance. They're all the same, and that's 25,000 favorable. The company simply spent 25,000 less in fixed overhead than they had originally budgeted. The production volume variance, and that's just the difference between the budgeted and the applied overhead. So that is a 6,000 unfavorable application. It's unfavorable because the company should have applied 600,000. It only applied 594,000. So what's included in the cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold calculation, in essence, is 594,000 versus 600,000. It's the combination of these two together, which actually give us a $19,000, in this case, favorable value for, in this case, over-allocated fixed manufacturing overhead. When it comes to variable overhead, we can also do a quick final summary. Depending on the textbook or the source, we can actually have a 3, 2, or 1 variance analysis. So we can create just a little table here that says we have a rate variance or spending efficiency and production volume. In a 3 variance analysis, we would combine the 22,000 unfavorable variable spending overhead variance and the 25,000 favorable fixed overhead budget variance to give us a $3,000 favorable net spending variance. Of course, the efficiency variance only comes from variable overhead. So the rate or spending variance is the variable overhead variance plus the fixed overhead variance. The efficiency variance is from the variable overhead only, and we know that to be 33,000 unfavorable from our previous work up here. And then the PVV variance is a fixed overhead only variance, and we know that is 6,000 unfavorable. If we wanted to do a 2 variance analysis, all we would do is show a column for the flexible budget variance and a column for the PVV variance. The flexible budget variances add up to 30,000 unfavorable, and then the 6,000 unfavorable PVV variance. And then a 1 variance analysis would combine those together to end up with a $36,000 unfavorable net overhead variance. And we could say, well, that's broken up into 55,000 unfavorable for variable overhead and 19,000 favorable for fixed overhead. And then we're done. That's how you do variable and fixed overhead variances.